Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. We're going to do this investment simple interest problem using one variable. Tim invested some money into a 10% annual simple interest account. In a 16% account, he invested $4,000 more than when he put in the 10% account. He earned a total of $2,200 in interest from these investments after 1 year. How much was deposited into each account? All right, so we don't know how much is invested in either account. We do know that he invested more money in the 16% account. In fact, $4,000 more than what he put in the first account. So I like to set this up in a chart, but before doing that, I'm just going to remind you about the simple interest formula. The basic simple interest formula is interest equals principal times rate times time, but if the time is 1 year, we just have the principal times the rate, or I usually like to think of that as the rate times the principal. The rate is the percentage rate. So here's our problem, and we have two different accounts. So what I'm going to do is make a little chart up to keep track of the kinds of accounts we have, the interest rate, how much we put in each account, and the interest earned. So we have what kind of accounts? We have a 10% account and a 16% account. So I'm going to write the rate using a decimal. So 10% is 0.10 or 0.1, and 16% is 0.16. Now, what about the principal? So we have to read through this again. Tim invested some money into a 10% annual simple interest account. So we don't know how much money, so let's go ahead and just let that be X, however much money that happens to be. In a 16% account, he invested $4,000 more than what he put in the 10% account. Okay, so if he put X amount of dollars in the 10% account and he invested $4,000 more in the 16% account, then we'd have X plus $4,000 invested in the 16% account, right? It's however much he invested here plus an extra. Be careful, just don't put 4,000, right? We don't know how much is in there. All we know is it's 4,000 more than was invested in this first account at 10%. So to calculate the interest, we just do the rate times the principal, right? That'll be the interest per year. So in the first account, we have 0.10 times x. And in the second account, we have 0.16 and times the entire principal, which is the x plus 4,000. Don't forget the parentheses. All right, so our chart is just keeping track of our rate, which is the percent, right, written as a decimal. The principal, P stands for principal, the amount of money you invest, and I is the interest, and we always get that from just multiplying our rate times our principal if we're talking about 1 year. What else do we know from reading this problem? He earned a total of $2,200. Okay, so the total amount of interest, right? In interest, total of $2,200 in interest from these investments. So however much he earned in interest from each account, when I add them together, it should add up to $2,200. So how much did he earn from the 10% account? Right here is how much he earned in interest for the 10% account. So we have that much money. That's how much interest he earned in that account. Plus, how much did he earn in the other account? He earned 0.16 times x plus 4,000. And how much money is that altogether? Well, it says it's a total of 2,200. So that interest amounts to 2,200. So that's what that adds up to. All right, now at this point, you can go ahead and work with decimals. I prefer not to work with decimals, so I multiply both sides of the equation by 100 in order to eliminate the decimals. But that's an option. If you want, you can work this problem without doing that. Just be careful, especially if you have a calculator, it's just as easy. I tend not to use a calculator if I don't have to, because there weren't any calculators around when I first learned algebra. So I'm used to doing a lot in my head in the old-fashioned way. So we have 100 times 0.10. Remember, when you multiply 100, you multiply by each term on each side. So when you have this middle term here that you see, the 0.16, x plus 4,000, that's just one single term. All right, you don't also multiply the x plus 4,000. So we have 100 times 0.10 will give me 10x. 100 times this, 0.16 times x plus 400, will move the decimal, this 16, over 2 to the right. You don't also multiply what's inside parentheses, because that means you'd be multiplying that term twice by 100. And then we have to remember to multiply the 2200 by 100 as well. You have to multiply both sides of the equation by the same number. So that gives me 2200 and two extra zeros for multiplying by 100. And so then this is an equation without decimals, so now I'm going to continue. So I have 10x plus, and I've got to distribute the 16 inside the parentheses. So we have 16 times x plus 16 times 4,000. All right, what will that be? Well, 16 times 4 is 64. You can get that by going 16 times 2, right, doubling it, and then multiplying by 2 again, which is 32, 64. So 64, and then the three extra zeros equals 220,000, right? So this is 64,000. All right, so let's see, if we combine like terms over here on the left, we'll have the variables on the left-hand side. So let's go ahead and also subtract 64,000 from both sides, so that we have only variables on the left side of the equation and only our constants on the right side. So this gives me 36x on the left-hand side. And on the right-hand side, what's that going to give me? Let's see, 0, 0, 0, 6, and I think that's 15, right? So I have 156,000. And now I am going to use a calculator for this. I'm going to divide both sides by 36. Oops, I just found a mistake. This was 26, not 36. All right, let's see. So this was 26, so I want to divide both sides by 26. All right, so let's see. Now I'm going to use my calculator. And I got x equals 6,000. Boy, you have to be so careful. All right, so x is 6,000. Now, what does x stand for? Look back up here at my chart, because that's where I'm keeping my information, where I'm defining my variables. X is the amount he invested at 10%, right? So if he invested, and I'll just write that real small here so you can see that. So that ended up being $6,000, right? If we did it right. So then how much is in this 16% account? Well, it's $4,000 more, which this is $10,000, right? So if we did everything right, he invested $6,000 at 10% and $10,000 at 16%. So we're going to hope that's the right answer by writing that down and then checking our answer. So we need to go back up to the original problem here. Okay, so here's the original problem. It looks like it's going to be $6,000 at 10% and $10,000 at 16%. Okay, so it looks like our answer is going to be $6,000. He's going to put in, invest $6,000 in the 10% account and $10,000 in the 16% account. We want to make sure that's going to be true. What would the interest in the first account be? The interest in the 10% account would be what? Well, it would be 10% of $6,000, which is $600 is what he would have made if he would have put $6,000 in the 10% account. How much would he make in that 16% account? Well, it says he placed 10,000 at 16%. So 16% of 10,000 would be, I think that's $1,600. Okay. So if he earned $600 in one account and $1,600 in the other account, that means he made $2,200. And if we look back at the problem, it says he earned a total of, here it is, $2,200. So it does check. So this is our answer. He invested $6,000 in the 10% account and $10,000 in the 16% account. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com where you can view all of my videos which are organized by topic.